Father's Day today. Yes. And
is it in the mail?
Quite interesting, yeah. I mean, here we are.
You're I should only, be tucked up in bed.
You're the only lad
yourself,
here today.
You should be getting breakfast in bed.
Yeah, you should.
You
half of the public want Britain's next Prime Minister to create a minister for men. I mean, honestly, you couldn't write
even
it.
Even I
you
can't agree with this, even just sat here with you three.
But this was a big poll done by ComRes for the Fathers4Justice group. They commissioned it, obviously, today, get big headlines. But they do sort of identify the fact that we do live in a Britain nowadays where an awful lot of men, an awful lot of dads today will not see their children. About a third, they reckon.
I think it's a 4 in 10, yeah.
Because of the, I don't know, because they're absent fathers, maybe they only think about their children on Father's Day, I don't know.
They're working.
They could be working, yes, indeed. Disaffected after a bad divorce. There are lots and lots of reasons. But it does seem extraordinary now that we're identifying that we have a crisis for some men. They don't seem to know where they're going. They don't understand who they are and what they're meant to be anymore. I don't know whether... I think the divorce rate is very, very cruel to a lot of men. Mm. And suddenly they're saying, well, actually, life is so hard for us, we now need a minister to look after our rights.
I'm not sure we need another minister for anything, though, do we, to be perfectly honest? I mean, what are they going to achieve? It's just, I don't think we need it. I think, you know, women, a lot of women out there, I think, oh, they need a minister for men after years of inequality, and now they want a minister for men. Yeah. I don't think so. That's one gift I don't really want.
Let's look at your paper, Michael. Nanny says don't email before bed.
Yes.